first of all, the project spoke to me. I went to work with Aegis. No, but also what was important about it, I think, you know, the political discussion, you got stuff about immigration, but also I think there's not that much content on TV that has a family that happens to be black or African. This is the first in many years, or the first ever. But also, you know, what I loved about it, that it wasn't just about them being African, it was about them being a family in the heart of East London. And I think what Aegis has created in Sky and Green Door is that you can create great content that it crosses over universally, all sorts of people from different demographics, races and ages, they watched it, they enjoyed it. And but also for me, that means that let's make more of that content, you know, let's trust, let's stop sort of going, well, we've not seen anything like that before, we don't know how it's going to go down. You know, if the content's good and you back it in its right way, that's like Sky backed in the long run, then we can have, I feel like, 10, 14 other types of in the long run. I don't mean comedies, I just mean, I mean inclusive, diverse content. That's what I mean, basically, you know? If you look at it, it's got great female characters, you know, it's got a great diverse cast, and also we had a great female director, the writer team was diverse, two women, two men, and, you know, and then you got, you know, the great producers as well. You got someone like Idris Elba, Gina Carter, and Charlie Hansen. I think, you know, when you look at the front and the back end of the show and how it's made up, for me, that's how sort of TV and film should be done. For Aegis, you know, him being back here in the UK now, I think he's conscious of the position that he's in. He doesn't have to do the work he's doing, but he's choosing to tell the stories he wants to tell, but also that fit in terms of what the current conversation is, and fits in with his speech that he did at the House of Commons, you know. And so, but also this is a personal story for him, so it was quite hard. His father passed quite a few years back, and so this is him sort of putting his personal story out there in the public. It's loosely based on his personal story, but it is. And so that's why I think it's important for him, but also he's very generous, Idris. He is trying to help bring talent through. Just like, you know, just like myself, I've got a company called Trifles Creative Network, and we do initiatives like Monologue Slam UK is a free actor showcase to be seen by diverse actors. We do film festivals. You know, it's one of the cheapest in the world, you know, to submit your films and to be seen by people at BAFTA. And I think Idris is all about, let me use my position to open the doors of the industry, because it's still a bit closed off, there's still a bit of nepotism, there's still a bit, you know, middle class and white male, and it's nice that Idris and Green Door and Sky are creating content that is, you know, challenging that situation.
So in the long run, it's one of my favourite jobs. It's been so much fun. Obviously there's all the music and stuff of the 80s, which just is so like vibrant and exciting and massive floor fillers. And but aside from the music, politically it isn't too dissimilar from now. We've got female in power, there's all sorts of stuff happening racially, there's all tensions building. Yeah, it is very, very similar, weirdly, 1985 to nowadays. And I've really enjoyed getting my teeth into like learning about that time, and have all the miners' strikes and Brixton riots. And I've really enjoyed it, like learning so much. And then the tunes. And Idris is cool, he's my boss. So it's a bit of a cool job for me.
Bill Bailey, her on-screen husband, can you talk a little bit about what it was like working with Bill, and how hard it is to keep a straight face when you're both wearing 80s attire as well?
I mean, Bill can rock a jumper like that. I don't know if you've seen some of the stuff that he wears, but he looks cool in them. Working with Bill's been great. He's a really intelligent, fun, naughty guy. He's a perfect second husband for me. I'm a big fan of his. We didn't sort of muck around too much, because, you know, we're both a bit nervous and wanting to get it right.
I believe there were some dance battles going on an offset. Who is the best dancer in the cast?
not Idris. No, he can move. Sammy, who I guess he plays Idris, he's a really good mover. And Matty Boyes, who plays my son, he's like a little Billy Elliot. I threw some shapes as well. But, I mean, everybody was pretty damn good at dancing, I've got to say. Yeah. What can people take away from it? Just like life is short, like have fun and stand up for your neighbours and your friends I just think it's a story that's about friendship and it's about family and I think that's what the message is. Like it's very family based, and I don't know about what people are going to take away all sorts of things from it, but I guess it shows like how history repeats itself, if anything.
Obviously, Idris is very much at the heart of this project. What makes him such a very special performer, do you think?
God, he's inspirational. It's his baby. It's his story. He's opened himself up. This is his life. It's about him coming over from, like I say, from Sierra Leone, and coming to England and his experiences as a young black boy. And he's kind of like warts and all, and he takes the piss out of himself and out of the time. And fair play to him. He's made it all happen. It's cool.